To give some context around this, let me just start by saying that, so when it comes to the treatment of lymphoma, both immune checkpoint inhibition as well as adoptive T-cell therapy have shown the potential, the great potential of T-cell therapy to control and eradicate both Hodgkin and non-Hodgkin lymphomas. For example, the very recent approval of a fourth CAR T-cell product targeting CD19 for the treatment of relapsed and refractory lymphomas highlights this enormous potential. However, more than half of patients that have been treated with CAR T cells will not reach a complete remission or will eventually relapse. And furthermore, not all lymphoma subtypes express CD19, which means that not all CAR T cell recipients, not all patients with lymphomas are eligible for the currently available CAR T cell treatments. So at Baylor College of Medicine, we have long studied expertise in the development and implementation of novel T cell therapies to treat a range of diseases. In our recent GCO publication, we are focusing on the development of a T cell therapy for lymphoma. So in this phase 1-2 trial that we are describing, we have generated an infused autologous T cells targeting 5 different tumor-expressed antigens for patients with relapsed and refractory Hodgkin and non-Hodgkin lymphomas of various subtypes. The aim of targeting 5 different tumor-associated antigens was dual. On the one hand, we wanted to extend the potential of this therapy to patients with all lymphoma subtypes, so irrespective of CD19 expression. And second, we wanted to minimize the risk of immune escape due to immune escape because of antigen negative immune escape. So in this study, we infused our multi-antigen specific T cells to 32 patients, 14 patients with Hodgkin and 18 with non-Hodgkin lymphomas. Prior to enrollment, the patients had received a median of 3 cycles of prior therapy and were infused either because they were at high risk of relapse or they were infused with active relapse and refractory lymphoma. The trial was performed in 2 parts. The first part was the antigen escalation phase, where we sought to determine the safety of targeting those five tumor-associated antigens simultaneously. The second part was the dose escalation phase, where we sought to determine the maximum tolerated dose of infused cells in vivo. What we show in the GCO paper is that these are products that are specific for up to 5 tumor-associated antigens and infused at up to 20 million cells per meter square twice. So 2 infusions, 2 weeks apart. So these cells can be safely administered to patients with all subtypes of lymphoma, so irrespective of disease status or lymphoma subtype. And the maximum tolerated dose was not reached. In the high-risk group, 82% of patients remained in complete remission on a long-term follow-up of at least 4 years. And most importantly, in the chemorefractory cohort with active lymphoma, 40% of patients achieved a complete remission, which was durable for more than 3 years. And furthermore, among clinical responders, what we found was that the clinical benefit following T-cell infusion was associated with antigen spreading, which means that the infused cells actually helped towards the recruitment and the activation of the endogenous immune system against additional tumor antigens, so different than those that our infused T-cells were targeting. To sum up, what we are showing in our GCO publication is that our autologous non-engineered multi-tumor antigen-specific T-cells are safe and are well tolerated by patients of various lymphoma subtypes and irrespective of disease status. So that happens both in the adjuvant setting as well as in the chemorefractory active disease setting. We saw objective clinical responses even in the chemorefractory patient cohort, and we also demonstrate a correlation of clinical benefit with immune effects mediated by both the infused cells as well as the activation of the endogenous immune system. When it comes to the lymphoma paper, the GCO published clinical trial, I would just like to emphasize that what our results show is that we can target an additional cohort of self-antigens that has not been targeted so far in combination, so as to try and actually, you know, add on this arsenal of immunotherapy approaches. Now is the age of immunotherapy. We all know that, and we feel that our approach, when it is further tested in a randomized setting, in larger cohorts of patients, in more carefully selected, we could actually show much stronger indications of clinical benefit and support these preliminary results.